Hi everyone, I'm Danny. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to discuss about how to care for Vanda orchids. Vanda orchids are those types of orchids that you see once and you fall in love for the rest of your orchid collecting hobby. But like all beautiful things, they are not the easiest things to keep. Not necessarily because they require unobtainable climates, but because they resemble nothing with your usual houseplant. Vanda orchids can come in a multitude of colors and patterns, and their flowers are considerably large in some cases. They produce multiple flowers on a single flower spike that can extend up to 30 centimeters in length. It's easy to see why this orchid fascinates orchid growers from all over the world. The question is, can any of us grow these orchids in our homes, even if we live in apartments? Well, the answer is yes. It's quite easy to do so, if you are prepared to make some room in your life for a Vanda orchid. Let us start with the growth habit of this orchid. Unlike other orchids, the Vanda prefers to be grown bare root, either mounted on a piece of wood or the tree trunk of a tree, either in a plastic or wooden hanging basket. The Vanda is an epiphytic orchid, thus its roots naturally attach to trees and branches in the wild, keeping the orchid very well fixed. It has adapted to a world above the ground, without constant moisture around the roots and nutrient-rich soils, but it's constantly ventilated by the winds. For this reason, Vanda orchids cannot be grown in pots with soil, as its roots would rot and die relatively fast. Growers manage to grow Vanda orchids in clay pots with a media consisting of chunky pieces of wood or other materials that do not retain water for long periods of time. The clay pot is used because it lets the roots breathe and also because this plant tends to grow tall and gets very top heavy. Plastic pots can be used as well, if they are ventilated and heavy enough. But the vast majority of growers prefer to keep this orchid hanging, bare-rooted. The root system of a Vanda orchid can get quite extensive, making some hybrids or species unruly and impossible to grow in pots. A healthy root system can grow a few meters in length, depending on the orchid's age and variety. The Vanda is a monopodial orchid, meaning it has a main stem from which leaves develop sideways. The stem can grow to be quite tall, and the width of the leaves is not small either. The fan can be as large as 40 centimeters across, depending on the species, while the stem can grow indefinitely across its life. So this would be the first problem a home grower will have to face: finding room in his house to accommodate an orchid of about 1 meter tall, top to root tips. The good news is that the Vandas are not fast growers. They grow 3 to 4 leaves each year, meaning that in about 5 years, a Vanda can grow approximately 15 centimeters. There are also smaller species and varieties available, but they will also produce much smaller flowers compared to a normal-sized Vanda orchid. Now that we know a bit about Vanda orchids, let's see how to care for them. The most important factor to take into account is light. These orchids are some of the most sun and light-loving orchids. They can withstand even direct sunshine, much better than other orchids. So try to find a very bright place in your home or growing area, like a southern exposure. Morning sun is ideal, as it's not very hot, depending on the season and climate, of course. Usually hot noon sun is to be avoided if temperatures are warm. Even Vandas can obtain burned leaves if they are not adjusted to sun. But a good idea is to use a sheer curtain to block some of the sun's rays and reduce its intensity. The light will still be bright, but the leaves will not get hot to the point of burning. Temperature is another important factor to keep in mind. These orchids are, in the majority of cases, intermediate to warm-growing orchids. The ideal temperatures for these orchids span from about 22-23 degrees Celsius to 27-28 degrees Celsius. Although extremes can be tolerated easily, they are not ideal. I believe this orchid is very well suited to warm and sunny environments rather than cold and gloomy ones. Watering this orchid is the most crucial aspect of its care, in my opinion at least, and it's important to understand it as it holds the key to keeping this orchid healthy and make it bloom regularly. As I was saying, this orchid likes to have its roots very well aerated, but keeping it properly hydrated is an absolute must. In a normal home, I found that soaking this orchid once a day maintains it healthy and in good condition. You can use a bucket in which you can place the orchid for about 10 to 15 minutes every day, preferably during the morning hours. In normal homes, the air can be too dry, so spraying or even showering the roots has proven to be insufficient, at least for me. I have filmed a tutorial in which I show you exactly how I water my Vanda orchids and how to know when it's time to water it. So click on the top right of your screen to watch this video tutorial, or find the link in the description of this video if you're using a mobile device. If you are lucky enough to grow your Vandas in a high humidity environment, soaking it might not be necessary. But usually this applies in greenhouses, where humidity is controlled, or very humid climates where Vandas are grown outside. If you grow your Vanda orchid in a pot with media, be sure to let the media dry out very well before you rewater. Fertilizing Vanda orchids is really important. It is best to use an orchid fertilizer about once a week or once every 2 weeks. I usually fertilize every week during my summertime and once a month in wintertime, but I live in a climate with very distinct seasons. If weather is warm and sunny all year round, in your region you might need to fertilize more often, even in wintertime. Vanda orchids can bloom throughout the year depending on climate. Mine usually bloom in spring, summer and autumn when temperatures are warm, while in winter they don't bloom at all due to the lack of light and low temperatures. Even so, these orchids are flourishing and adapted very well to the changes in seasons. A Vanda can bloom once a year, twice, or even 3 times, depending on species or variety. Usually, the hybrids you can easily find at grocery shops or garden centers are complex hybrids and they bloom multiple times a year. Vandas come in many shapes and forms. You can find tall Vanda orchids with big showy blooms, or smaller varieties with dainty flowers, well suited for small spaces. All you need to do is visit your local garden center, orchid greenhouse, or online store and browse through the varieties. It is best to research your orchid first if you know its name, and see what other people are saying about it. As for the Vandas shown in this video, you can click on the info card on your screen now or visit the links in the description of this video to learn more about them and their identification. I hope you found this video useful and you will consider trying to grow a Vanda orchid next. They are not fussy orchids and can prove to be rather resilient and adaptable to home environments. If you have further questions or I forgot to mention something, feel free to leave me a comment below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. If you've enjoyed this video, then please give it a like and a share, subscribe to my channel for daily orchid videos, and consider supporting us by leaving a one-time or a monthly tip on orchidnature.com. While you are there, you can browse the identification section, care sheets, and forums. You can also click on the right side of your screen to see another orchid video that might give you some new tips. Thank you for joining, I'll see you next time, bye!